So guys, our circuit is fully complete and now it is time to connect it to a 12 volts power supply and test it. Now my power supply is on and now it is time to connect the positive wire. So here I've upgraded my heat sinks for maximum heat dissipation and protection of my MOSFETs. Don't forget to use the electrical separators. The no load current is as high as 1.8 amperes and load current at present it is 4. Well, it will depend on objects. Now the power supply that I'm using is 12 volts 8 amperes. So let's turn on the switch to see the amperes here. And here as you can see that it is drawing almost full. So moving on with the temperature measurement for my induction heater, as we can see the room temperature is 23 degrees. Let's turn it on. And here the temperature is rising rapidly. Now the temperature has reached to a max of 616 degrees and then it stopped measuring the temperature, which means that it was the maximum this multimeter could measure. Test 2 with my must tool clamp meter. So we are doing 500 degrees. Let's see it can cross 600. Yeah, it is crossing 600. So we have reached 665 degrees centigrade and this is red hot. Here I've soldered these three jumper wires. So let's solder my new circuit to this setup. So turning on the supply. So let's do the temperature measurement of this plate. Turning on. Now increasing the air gap and testing it again. Temperature is 21.8 degrees. It's on. Temperature is rising. No more buzzing sound. Let's see how high we can get. So finally we have crossed 100 degrees. Oh, this is pretty good. Well, it reached around 150 degrees and the plastic tape melted, because of which this point was no longer in contact with the plate. So anyways, I believe it should be enough for melting my solder. Let's turn it on. You can see the flux melting and smoking. Wow, it's amazing performance. It's very hot. Turning it off. So as you can see that it is working very well plus continuously, and the heat sinks are still not hot enough. Pretty good performance. Time for the new product unboxing. So So guys, I've been waiting for this product for a long time because it is a 3D printer filament dryer. I'm glad that this kind of product is now available in the market. Link has been provided in the description below. So the packaging includes SoWall 3D filament dryer, its charger, and the product manual. Now the finish quality is so good and it is so compact, weighing only 1.2 kgs. With 48 watts power rating. Now the transparency helps us to keep track of the left filament, and the snap buttons keep the inside isolated from the outside. So this is how it looks from inside. Below is the heating plate, and these are all on bearings for the filament holder to roll. Plus, there is also this cooling fan. Now, I have these two unused and damaged filaments. You see, it's brittle. Same for this one. So, I'm planning on restoring these two filaments with my new machine. So, this is how it looks. Now, let's connect the charger. So now we are ready to go. Turning it on. Oh, it is touch. So at present, the temperature is 21 degrees centigrade and 59% is humidity. Function button. Time is 6 hours. Now it's on. So here it is flashing work. And like it is removing the humidity and increasing the inside temperature, taking it to as high as 40 degrees. And we can set the temperature with the mode button. So let's leave it like this for 6 hours and then come back. One important note, make sure you close this lead button. It is opened only when you want to use the filament during the drying process. So after completing the moisture removal process, let's check it. Starting with the yellow one. Yeah. You see, it is no longer brittle. This is amazing. The PLA strength has revived. You see? Amazing. Now the blue one. This is really brittle. I think I will have to repeat the same process and see if it revives or not. And the blue one is not working because this one is much older than that one. Let's repeat it. So after repeating the process the second time, let's test it. Ah, you see? Nope. Yeah, at some points it is fine, at some it is not. Like here it is very strong. Again, oh, yeah, now it is working, you see? Nice. It has finally revived the filament. Yeah, this one is fine now. Yeah, this one is also fine. Wow, so finally both of my discarded 3D filament rolls have been revived. Important note, make sure that you leave a gap between the metal plate and the ferrite core. Otherwise, for some reason, beyond 80 degree plate temperature, the switching stopped and the circuit went under short circuit condition. 2. Circuit diagram. 3. In total, I have given 12 turns to the ferrite core winding